Now our topic is diatomic gases. In this topic, we have energy of one diatomic molecule, and that is E is equal to phi by 2. It is kBT. So that's our energy for only one molecule. Now if we are having Avogadro numbers of molecules, then total energy of that number of atoms U is equal to 5 by 2 kBT. This is for only one. Now we have to multiply with that Avogadro number, so we get all the energies, right? So that is U. Now we have to differentiate this energy with respect to temperature, so we are getting here 5 by 2 kB into Na, dT by dT will be 1, okay? So that is dU by dT, and that means it is CV, means specific heat at constant volume, okay? So this is CV, and KB into Na, we can write it as capital R. Again, we are having one equation, Cp minus CV is equal to R. Put this formula here, Cp is equal to R plus CV. So Cp is equal to R plus 5 by 2 into R, it will be 7 by 2 into R, right? So that is Cp, and that is 7 by 2 into R. Now we can find for gamma. So gamma is equal to Cp upon Cv, it will be 7 by 5, right? See, if we are having diatomic gases, this all the energies is for only O2 and 2 like. Means similar like atoms, but if we are having CO atom, it is also diatomic, but it is different. This is carbon, this is oxygen. So now our energy, total energy will be E is equal to 7 by 2 kBT instead of this equation. So here now we have 7 by 2, right? So direct comes to this formula, we are getting CV is equal to 7 by 2 into R, CP, then we get 9 by 2 into R, and after all gamma will be Cp upon Cv, so we get 9 by 7. So that's our diatomic gases.